How's it going, guys, and welcome to this ArmA 3 mission editor tutorial using the new 3D Eden editor for ArmA 3. Please take note that the cinematic introduction was just a cinematic representation of what we'll be learning today. So no learning how to do cinematics, it's just going to be a tutorial on how to create, kill, or destroy objectives. I made a video in the past on it using the old ArmA 3 editor, which should look something like this, minus the new fancy UI that we have. And I'll put a link up in the description if you guys want to check that out. It's nothing special, trust me. But anyway, I was reading the comments recently, and some people saying they couldn't get what was in the video to work within the new Eden editor. So here we are today to show you how it works. It's basically the exact same thing in that video, minus one thing. But that's nothing catastrophic, or it doesn't have any major effect on the outcome of the mission. I'm going to press E and R to bring up these tabs. So the first thing you want is a playable character. You can either place a group down and select a playable character out of that, or place down a single character, which is under the F1 or F2 options depending on what you want. I've got one copy pasted ready since I've customized my own character here. You want to double left click and make sure they are, or the character you want to be playable is playable, so I'm going to make him the player. The next step is you want an enemy combatant to kill, so we're going to be focusing on the kill or assassination type objective currently. I'm going to place down an enemy combatant. I'm going to place down an African rebel. Place him in the middle of the street, just for no reason whatsoever. I'm going to rotate him around, so I'm going to hold shift and click on him, and that enables me to rotate him, make him face up the street. Now what you want to do is double left click and give him a variable name. In this case, we're going to name him Bob because it's short and simple. The next step is we want to add modules, which is F5 on the keyboard, or these three blocks. Click on, head down to Intel. Now you want to create a task, you can put it wherever you like, it doesn't really matter. Play it down, and if you double left click, you can customize task ID, title, and description. The task ID is just going to be kill, that's what I'm going to call it. Title, full bold. Description, okay. The world. There we go. So the next step is we want to place down another module, which is also under Intel, and that's set task state. I'm going to lay that down there. Double left click, and we're going to change the state from created to succeeded. Now with the old editor, it looks something like this. Modules used to group themselves to each other, so you'd have to click the grouping option, click on the one of the grouped modules, and click and drag out, and they wouldn't be grouped anymore. We don't have to do it anymore because they do not automatically group to each other, which is nice. Even though it wasn't like a major thing to editing, it was quite annoying that you had to ungroup so many modules all the time when you made big missions. And it got quite annoying, so I'm glad Bohemia removed that. So next we want a trigger, which is F3, or this flag icon, click on it. I'm going to choose the top option since we don't need an area around the trigger that can set the trigger off, and it's going to have no activation or anything like that. So we want to double left click, and in condition, we want to type exclamation mark, alive, space, and then the variable name, which is Bob in this case, semicolon. So there we go. Now the next step is we want to sync all these together. So we're going to sync the trigger to the set task state by right clicking, going to connect, sync to, and then set task state. Now we're going to do the same thing for the rest of this, which is sync that to that, and this to that. There we go. So basically, when Bob dies, it's going to trigger off the trigger, which will trigger this the objective or the task to succeeded, as we've said it here. It's going to die, trigger that off, and it's going to trigger the task, succeeded, and since it's connected to, you know what his name is, we'll call him Jeff for no apparent reason, the objective will be complete. Now, when you have a create task, you sync it to the character that you want to have the task or the objective. If you have a squad, so let's place down a random squad, just for no reason, put down a sniper team. When you sync it towards the team leader or the squad leader or whatever, and anyone under the squad leader will also have the objective. But we're not going to need these guys today. Just going to delete these guys now because we don't need them. So yeah, anyone that, if you sync under the squad leader or the team leader, everyone under him will have the objective. So we'll test this out now. Sorry if it takes quite a load, I'm running a crap ton of mods. A lot of mods, I think you're like 20 something at the moment. Will everything load? There we go. So when we kill Mr. Bob over here, it should trigger off to complete. And it didn't load completely because it lagged a little bit. Anyway, so Bob's dead and the mission is complete. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add a destroy part to this objective here. So I'm going to come up here to F1, the single object, head to this yellow icon over here, click props, and I'm going to add in something to blow up. It doesn't matter what you want to blow up, you can add a vehicle or weapons crate, things like that, and you just give it a variable name and it can be a part of the mission. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to head to equipment, no, where is it? What would it be under? Supplies. I just had a brain fart there. Look there. Supplies, we're going to go to ammo, and we'll look for something to blow up. African optical gearbox. We'll place it down, the same as Bob here, we're going to double left click, and give it a variable name. And it lets me do it, there we go. We're going to name it C1. And we want to head back down to the trigger, and add that part in. So double left click, we're going to remove the exclamation mark, I'm going to hold shift and double tap 7 to bring up these two fancy ands, and we're going to repeat the process, so space. Don't need capitals, alive, space, and then the variable name, which is C1, and exclamation mark. So every time you want to add something to the specific task, you just give it a variable name, and to keep the process going, you just start adding those fancy ands, and alive. If we had a second crate, which I'd name C2, we'd add that in, and I'd have to destroy two crates. In this case, we only have one, so we don't have to worry about that. When you add something else, and you might want to the stuff, but since I'm lazy, to add search and destroy or kill and destroy, I can't be bothered. So we're going to kill Bob here and destroy that, and it should trigger this off, and the whole process will be done again, and hopefully the objective will be complete. We're going to let everything load in this time so there's no little lag spike. And I forgot to remove Ace Hearing, which adds like eardrum effects, which is quite annoying, but oh well. So since I'm running Ace 3, I'm going to have to lay down explosives differently to what most of you guys might have to do, which is just scroll wheel in place. Now I have to interact with the bloody damn thing, which I'm going to do now. I'm going to set a trigger, blow that thing up using a device. So I'm going to run out here, so when this blows up it should check that to mission complete. It should be far enough. I'm not gonna fool myself here. Alright. Let's set that off. God damn it. Oh, I did it. Alright, here we go. Boom. As you can see, the objective is complete. So what I've showed you today should be very helpful in creating assassination type missions, search and destroy, kill and destroy, all those types of things. You can create your very own nice little mission. So if you guys enjoy this type of thing and want to see more of it, click subscribe and don't miss out on the future tutorials that I will be doing. If you guys had any ideas or thoughts on this video, leave a comment down below, good or bad. Tell me what I did good, tell me what I did bad and need to improve on. And that's about it. Hope you guys did enjoy, and I'll catch you guys later.